Hello everyone, I'm going to be testing 1 rupee stationery today. So I got all these things from a wholesale market near my home and the whole packs cost around 10 rupees. So I got 10 sketch pens for 10 rupees, that makes each one for a rupee, and these crayons and this sketchy palette. So we're going to be testing all of these, especially the quality and how they perform. And then you can choose if you want to buy it for yourself or whether you should be gifting these things as a return gift as well or not. So the first item that we shall test will be these crayons. Let's start with wax crayons. So the name is what sounds very sketchy to me because it is an Indian name, but I don't get it. Now this box cost me, I think, rupees... Oh, it says MRP 7, but I have a wild guess that I paid rupees 10. Now the moment I take them out, the first thing I see is that there's no packaging. I don't think I've ever gotten wax crayons without any label on them. This is kind of good because there's no glue that got mixed with them, but they look very, very flimsy. So let's test them out. So I have these blank pages to test them. The first thing that we shall test is how dark are they? Okay, they're very rough, very chalky. Usually wax crayons are supposed to glide. I can literally hear when I'm coloring, see? This sounds like a pencil, not a crayon. That's bad. I'll try to go even harder, probably use the back. Even the back is so scratchy. I'm going really hard here, and this is the darkest these can get. I don't like it. Let's try another color. Probably a darker one. The formulation could be different. Okay, this scratches much less. But isn't this supposed to be black? This is clearly gray. See, this is what I'm talking about. Wax crayons should not have these spaces. They're supposed to be like a stark line, you know? Yeah, something like that. But this is also chalky. So these are the worst set of crayons I have ever come across in my life. I highly recommend you to not give this to anyone. Don't even buy these for yourself because they are very chalky. I don't even think this is wax and they don't even perform like a proper crayon. So yep, a big thumbs down for sure. This next thing that we're going to test, I'm sure you must have received this as a return gift when you were a kid. Now this is some cartoon themed pencil, sharpener and eraser, and the generic color pencils. So as a child I would always get attracted to the cartoons, but now that I am a grown up, I think I will be able to look past the packaging and actually be able to judge the quality. This whole pack cost me only 20 rupees, so if they work, I think it's a good deal. Let's test them. Unboxing the cheapest stationery. Okay, this is cute as well, but I don't see any use for this. Now the first thing I'd like to test is the pencil and the sharpener. Already this finishing is not good. Stuff is coming out even before I put in, and the sharpener seems to have rusted a little bit, but we shall still try. That's sharp, definitely sharp, doing its job. The sharpener is good. Oh, I remember making flowers with these shavings. Let's see how smooth it is. Okay, this is actually not bad. This is, you know, this is smoother than the crayons that we tried before this. Good pigmentation as well. If you apply pressure, you are getting dark lines, and it's smooth enough to carry through. Let's try to color inside a circle. Probably not the best for shading because I'm not comfortable doing this, but you can definitely use it for generic purposes. It is good quality. So I give the pencil a pass. And the sharpener passes well, it did a good job. Also the sticker is stuck very well, I don't think this is going to come off anytime soon. Now I think the eraser is the thing that I'm most worried about. Usually cheap erasers do not perform. Also there is no way I can push it out, like I will have to tear the wrapping off. which I hate. Like, princess's ka sar to idhar hi kat gaya. Now let us test the lightest part first. Yep, I think this is erasing. No, wait, I can still see lines, and this is like the lightest. Let's try this now. Not good. Let me apply more pressure. No, this is not gonna. So as expected, the eraser is a bummer. So far, the success rate is 2 out of 3. Let's check the color pencils now. First thing that we will do is write. Oh, these are smooth. Again, these are smoother than the crayons. Okay, so the orange is the smoothest. The second smoothest is the green and the blue. Wow, look at how smooth that is. Okay, this is very chalky compared to orange, but still better than the crayons. I am ready for my verdict. So this pack was a hit and a miss, but more of a hit as compared to a miss. I think the success rate was more than 60%, and for that I think this is a great deal. My only thing is, if you have to gift this to someone, to jo eraser hai andar and a couple pencils are not the best, so maybe you could buy it in bulk and take out the erasers and put in your own eraser if you want. But otherwise, I think for 20 rupees the pencil, the sharpener and most of the color pencils were really good, so I give this a thumbs up. Our next item is this pack of sketch pens. The reason why I can title this video testing 1 rupee stationery, because literally each sketch pen comes down to 1 rupee. Now the brand name is either Lezing or Kiddo, but what attracts me is that kis pe wah likha hai. Like, that is such an Indian touch. Another thing is that they have written non-toxic, so I really hope that this is actually non-toxic and it's not written just for the sake of writing it. The MRP is 15 rupees for 12 pieces, but I got 12 pieces for 10 rupees. So this is actually even less than 1 rupee per sketch pen. So let's test these. The real test begins. Neon yellows used to be my favorite. This video is going to be my favorite to film. Itana nostalgia. Oh, yep, this one performs very well, especially for a marker which costs like less than 1 rupee. I don't even know how much that comes down in dollars actually. This one is not my favorite because it's much dull compared to that, but that's how yellow is, right? I don't think this is going to come up on the other side. This is so consistent. Yep, very neat. Oh, I think the nib of this is way shorter than the others. So the product that I was expecting to be the least performing performed so well, except a couple glitches. So the light green one had its defect and the brown took a while to warm up. But apart from that, the smoothness of all the sketch pens, it's brilliant. This is as good as any branded sketch pen pack I've tried. So the biggest thumbs up so far. Here comes the thing I'm excited the most to try. That was completely wrong grammar. That's how excited I am. I love painting. Painting is probably my most favorite form of art. And when I saw this, it looked very attractive, but I have very less hopes for this. So let's see how it performs. We do get a brush with it, which is usually pathetic quality in most cases. Jhaadu dete yaar saath mein. I'll try it with less water and hope that it won't be this diluted. Yeah, we're right. Wow. Oh, this could do well for a water marble thing. Okay, let's try a fresh color. I know I didn't clean my brush. It's fine. Utna nahi aayega. Yeah, This is more pigmented, but not as pigmented as good quality watercolors are, to be honest. बहुत घिसना पड़ेगा तभी जाके एक ओपेक लेयर मिलेगा. Okay, it's time to give the verdict. No, I can't even add verdict with this. I think it performed horribly. The thing is that if you are going to paint opaque with it, I think it will be decent. But I think you can do only solid painting. I do not think you can actually mix two colors because the paper already started getting rough with mere water, mix a little bit of color. So for kids, I would highly recommend you to not give it to them because they're still learning. And when they're learning, you should give them a product which is easier to work with as against a product which was so difficult to work with. Yeah, I give this a thumbs down. The next thing we have is a hilarious pack of a Minion color book. Now for this particular set, I'm not going to be using the blank papers. I will be using the book that they gave itself because if it's a kit, then the products that came in the kit should go well with each other. So let's see. This whole kit cost me rupees 70. So if this performs, we will decide if it was worth the money or not. And let's have our first look at the book. Oh, paper is very, very thin. The GSM is very low, I feel. Oh, wait, are these stickers? Hey, these were supposed to be stickers. You can't just randomly give this. So, card ke chipkane kaun wala hai? I think the difficulty level goes higher as you proceed. If they planned this, it was nice. Now, for yellow, we have only this neon one, unlike the other set we saw. So I'll have to go with the neon yellow in the Minion, which I'm not very happy with. Okay, this is making the paper rough already. Only if I go over it 2 to 3 times is it giving a good pigment. Yeah, this is better, way better. Let's give a couple more colors a fighting chance. Okay, time for our verdict. For 70 rupees, I have to directly give them a thumbs down because I have a strong feeling that the 10 rupee sketch pens actually perform better. And for 70 rupees, I think you can get branded sketch pens which definitely perform like super, super nice. I do know that you get this coloring book and the compass. But I think you can get this for much cheaper alag se in which ways, and the coloring book is really not the best quality. Isse acha to tum ghar pe print out nikalo of Minion coloring templates and give that to someone. I think that'll be better. So overall, I have to give this a thumbs down. And our last set of products are these cute pens. I got each of them for only 20 rupees. That's brilliant as against getting them online from Wish, where you would get one pen for like 50 or 100 rupees. Let's just test them and see how they perform. The first one we will test is this Minion version. It has a Minion print, which is actually pretty solid. It is not going to come off. And the googly eyes with the spring. This pen is not the smoothest, definitely not the smoothest. If you go for the ink, this is not worth 20 rupees. Is this refillable? Yes, it is. So probably you could get a much better quality refill once this is over. But I have to give this one a thumbs down. The next one is this unicorn pen. Now this is like the pens which are very much in trend, so I'm glad I could find this at a local wholesale gift shop. Let's see how this one performs. Oh, this is way better already. It's performing well with curves, not giving me that many jerks. Yep, have to give this a thumbs up. The worst looking thumb ever. And the last item is my most favorite one because I have had this pen as a kid and it's brilliant and I've broken it probably. Okay, wait. So this is supposed to light up when you write with this. Oh, so you can actually write and manage to not light it up, but if you apply pressure, it will light up. So I think if you write cursive, this is decent with curves, not the best, but it didn't stop me that much. Then we have a stamp on the top. The stamp is actually the same in pattern as the sticker on top. Not bad. And the final feature is blowing bubbles. It freaking worked. It worked. What? The item that was most worth the money in this whole video was definitely this pen. This gets like 100 thumbs up, okay? Love it. I am still obsessed with this pen and I'm going to be for the longest time. And this was me trying all these super cheap stationery items for you. I think the success rate was pretty good considering everything was so damn cheap and from a wholesale shop. So if you found this video helpful, do give it a thumbs up because I do these videos so that you can be helped from it and I can have colorful marks on my hands because this is an excuse for me to come back to stationery. And yes, I will see you in the next video. Until then, goodbye!